Alexander valiantly trying to fight back. Blocks the kick by Neville. Oh! And responds with a eviscerating elbow. And spring roundhouse kick right to the side of Neville's head.
Neville spills out to the apron. And now the floor.
Somehow, some way, Cedric Alexander has battled himself back into this match.
But now what he needs to do is do what Neville did. He needs to be ruthless. He needs to take advantage of this opening and take it to Neville like Neville's been taking it to him.
It looks like Cedric's going to want to capitalize through the sky.
Oh! Caught here by Cedric Alexander.
Landed on his feet.
Let's go. Neville lands on his feet. Standing Spanish fly by Cedric Alexander! Wow!
It doesn't get any closer than that without the bell ringing.
Lumbar check.
Oh, Neville lands on his feet. Oh! Beautiful German suplex. Released by Neville.
Neville was able to withstand the offensive flurry of Cedric Alexander and plant Cedric with a... Oh, can we be seeing another one? No way.
The deadlift.
The strength of Neville on display, deadlifting Cedric Alexander. And another German suplex with the bridge. And Alexander able to escape. Alexander looking for that sunset powerbomb, but Neville lands on his feet.
Neville goes down in the center of the ring. Cedric Alexander's got to be plotting his next move. What is Cedric waiting for?
Alexander looking for the pièce de resistance, looking to put away Neville. What? No, it's dark. Oh, and he gets wiped out by Cedric Alexander with the preemptive strike.
What is Noam Dar doing out here? The hesitation cost Alexander, and Cedric is in the center of the ring in a world of agony.
And Alexander forced to tap out. The scissored armbar by Neville. Like a torture device on Cedric Alexander.
Here's your winner by submission, Neville.
Wow. Dar not finished taunting Alexander. Oh, Neville, nonplussed, and Neville dispatches Dar. I was gonna say Alexander may have lost, but he proved that he can hang with the upper echelon of the cruiserweight division. What's Neville doing?
Cedric didn't beat Neville. Neville didn't want any help. Maybe that's why he tossed Dar to the outside so unceremoniously. Neville wants to do this all on his own.
Absolutely, Corey. Neville's not here to make friends. He's not trying to make allegiances.
Here comes the Cruiserweight Champion.
And Rick Swann has seen enough, and he goes immediately on the attack on Neville.
I don't know how smart this is. I would have stayed back if I was the champion. I wouldn't risk injury.
Well, this is personal, Austin. Oh, there's more than just the Cruiserweight title on the line this Sunday at the Royal Rumble.
And look at the opportunistic Dar. On the attack again, oh, but Alexander turns the tables and eliminates Noam Dar.
This is the sort of aggression we need to see from Rich Swann if he wants any chance of keeping Neville out of the 205 live flow.
And Rich Swann sending a message to Neville Monday night on Raw, and hostilities renewed here tonight, just 5 days away from when they will face each other for the WWE Cruiserweight Championship at the Royal Rumble event.
Things have completely broken down. Chaos.
They can't keep these guys apart.
They can't keep Swann off Neville.